There's no place to escape to.
This is the last straight.
On the left.
From your glaze.
That's when the cannibalism started.
What was that?
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to the last stream on the left. Hope you're having a fine Tuesday.
It's over now because your Tuesday's about to get fucked.
I want to thank Sergeant Pepper Dimples for this. That's very nice. Look at that. It's a sticker.
It's a very nice sticker.
Oh, is it a sticker? What does it say?
It says, "Hail yourselves with a little heart and you makes me look kind of thin."
Oh, so that is like nice. It. It's good, yes. Good lighting, good shaving of the Photoshop of your face. But otherwise, at the same time, you're still handsome. You got good bones.
Well, that's the problem. Everyone talks about Photoshop, how bad it is for models. As a Kmart model, Photoshop me. Trim it down. Why are they complaining?
They totally could have shrunk you. No. It was a personal vendetta, and they were absolutely frightened of you.
Yeah, that's true.
So this is my mandate.
That's right.
Feels so good to have the ball. I got the rock. I'm going to take it across the finish line. I think that's what it's called. I'm going to take the rock. I'm going to put it between the posts.
Uh-huh. That is not a sports reference at this point. You've made it a sexual reference. However, you did use a euphemism for a football.
Mm-hmm. So thank you. No, the rock. I thought rock is
basketball. That's basketball. The post, that's football.
I don't know.
He mixed the two.
I think it can go either way.
So a couple things we're going to do today. We're going to be taking calls, but we're going to take them at the end of the night.
That's it.
So you're going to get them. So we're going to get some people are going to call. We're going to put you on fucking a hold. And what you guys have to do is if you don't entertain us, you're fucking spiked. Okay?
Another football reference.
Yeah. Okay.
Wow.
It's my mandate.
Or a Jonestown reference.
And the first thing I would like to say is that the way I started my mandate was that I was coming down in the elevator leaving my apartment, and I farted like big time. I ripped it up. Doors open. Full family comes in with the dog. Two little, but the sweetest little kids just walking in the elevator, just sitting in my fucking freak mess.
Good job,
just,
buddy.
Like, ripping it up because I've been eating beans.
That was your inspiration for tonight's last stream?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
That was for my performance. Thank you, Turdner. Getting a lot of compliments on the shirts, and I will take them. So what we're going to do is, I'm not sure what order we should do this in. Titties, what we got up first?
Well, on theme, on brand with what you just said, let's go with the Star Wars homage.
Are you confident?
Oh, yes.
Are you confident in these biddies?
We'll see.
Henry?
We'll see. You know what? I've stopped caring. I hope that what it does is that you guys is all just going to, you're just riding with what I've decided what made me entertained.
Uh-huh. Happy birthday yesterday, Gurney Sanders.
Happy birthday, Gurney Sanders.
Congrats.
Let's fucking fire it up.
Oh, look at that. Right on theme.
It's cute. It's cute so far.
Jab of the butt.
I see. It is
it's
an
kinda,
actual.
That's kind of telegraphed there, yeah.
I guess he's... Oh, wow.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
Now, how did he do that? How did that happen?
I don't know. You must be French. I guess that's what happens. I don't know how you have complete and total control of your farts like that.
I see. Job of the butt.
What you do is you suck in the air. Some people can actually suck in the air through their anus and then pop it back out. There was a guy in France back in the early 1900s. He called himself, I think it was
Le Petit Pétard,
which means the little fart. Oh. And he used to be able to do like full symphonies with his farts.
Well, it seems like they're bigger farts.
Yeah.
That seems like there was also a guy on Howard Stern who could do that. And endless entertainment for millions of radio listeners.
This guy figured out that he could do it one day when he was swimming in the ocean and he accidentally sucked a bunch of salt water up into his asshole.
What if you got a starfish up in there? I was watching the new Blue Planet. Have you guys been watching New Blue Planet?
It's great. No. Yeah. The desert episode's the
man.
Best.
Oh, man. They're fucking, no, the new Blue Planet,
oh,
not
Blue
Planet Earth.
Planet.
They're different. Because that one's the water. And the one I was watching was the one with all the sweet... It was starfish are fucking freaky.
I don't like them.
The whole time you watch them... Because they will, like, and they flap along, right? And they're kind of being like, I can see how at some point and some an Asiatic member of the human race saw one and just like snapped it on his cock. Because those things can really suck, not like your old Betsy from back in Indiana.
I don't like the angler fish. I hate it.
Join the fucking...
Get out of here.
The list. Get on the fucking line.
A street lamp in a 1930s detective film. Get out of here. It's a lie.
Titties, let's shoot another one down the fucking bucket. I don't know what we got going on here.
Let's have some fun. Yay! Who wants to slam my head in the fridge?
Look at those things. Love this video. This actually reminds me of childhood. Look at that. Oh my.
Oh God.
Look at that.
You really like this one.
I love it. Huh.
Oh God! It's got my Harlan Williams.
Wait, is that Harlan? The Harlan Williams?
Yes.
From Dumb and Dumber. That's Harlan. That's what he's up to now.
That's what he does now. He has an entire YouTube channel where he makes a bunch of videos just like that, and they are. He's very, 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 very bad, and a lot of just videos of his fucking face, and he is all just very drunk looking, and all just blown out. His eyeballs, he's got big old like sacks under his eyes.
Well, how old is he now? He's got to be in his early 50s, maybe. He's probably old mid-50s. Enough to actually be a highway patrolman.
Could you check that out, Travis?
Yeah, how old is Harlan Williams?
You know, he stole Dumb and Dumber. Oh. That scene is so iconic, and he went against Jeff Daniels and Jim Carrey.
And there's something about Mary.
Eight-minute
abs.
There it is.
No, he was great, and then he just dropped off the face of the fucking planet.
Yeah, I'm sure it wasn't 55. Hollywood.
55. He's 55. Mid-50s.
Let's see a picture of him close up. I haven't seen Harlan Williams in forever. Good for him making it this long. All right.
He's not that bad.
No, he's doing a hell of a lot better than Andy Dick.
Well, this is a good picture. That's very flattering.
That is not current, though.
You don't think that's current? That looks from 55.
I do not think that's current.
I like it. Get that facial hair going. Let him know it's like, I'll be your stepdad. I mean, that's nice.
About LA in general, where all the men have their eyes just like tucked.
Right.
It's all this stuff where it's the... Where nothing else is tight except for right here, and they kind of look Asian.
Yeah, they all look like Paul Manafort. I don't get why anyone thinks that that's a good idea. You know, a little wrinkle around the eyes means you're wise, you're smart, you've seen a lot of things. Harry,
that's more like it.
Obviously, looks better than Adam Carolla. He looks better than Carolla.
No, he does. No, he does. Look at it. I guess he looks fine.
You know what he has, Henry? A nice head of hair.
Yeah. Yeah, he does.
Sergeant,
this is my fucking mandate. This is my mandate, okay? And I didn't come here to fucking deal with your fucking comments, all right? Because they also say that the baldness has got to do with a larger amount of testosterone, and people that have a larger amount of testosterone, I remember that film. But people have a larger amount of testosterone, want to stay in relationships longer and keep their partner more fulfilled sexually.
All right, I'm sure they say that.
Yeah. And that's how I do it, too. I start like this and go, Natalie, come here. And then she gets closer and closer. And then I grab on him. That's the first thing.
Chip and Joanne Gaines.
So what you're saying is that bald men hold on to the women they have tighter.
Yeah.
And try harder sexually.
We fuck harder. We fuck harder because our testosterone goes to our dicks. All right?
Necessity.
Just get over it. Give me the next one.
All right.
Give me the next one. The next video.
Not sure if that has a lot to do with testosterone.
Shut up. This one's for Marcus. This one is actually for Marcus, so I hope that he likes
you.
It.
Thank you. Ooh-wee.
You know why I like this one is that it reminds me of us.
Oh my.
It kind of makes me hungry.
This is very indicative of our friendship.
It's our family.
Look at that. Wow.
Yeah, I loved it.
Thomas the Freak Engine there. That is some scary stuff.
I just like him being, I just like him made out of all meat.
Mm. Yeah, I like that Thomas the Tank Engine.
Do you?
He's always working.
Yep, there he is.
Marcus has a small head, says, man, I want Henry to have sex with me.
I do have a small head.
I have a big head. Don't, you cannot judge Martin. Everyone judges you. Mm-hmm. You're sitting next to me. Yeah. I am the big one.
No, you're the big one. And I actually feel like I know that makes you a bigger target, but also at the same time, you're going to die earlier.
Mm. How is that supposed to make me feel better?
Gotcha. Gotcha. You were thinking and listening. Is he going to make me feel better? Never.
At the last Elimination Chamber, which Braun Strowman should have won, they had a preview for Andre the Giant. They got a new doc coming out on HBO.
Oh,
it looks awesome, but my God, is that the same conclusion to my life?
Man, no, they just showed bigger than you.
He was much bigger, but yeah.
There's something about
I think I could do it. Because he would house like 74 beers a night.
Yeah.
And the beers were like little Molsons, but they were like normal sized. I think I could have hung out with him. I think might have been able to do it.
Just start doing it. I'm certain Brooke will love it. I'm certain every one of your loved ones will love it. Getting up to 74 a day. You know what's also about Andre the Giant specifically, who's also a Gerard Depardieu thing, is the wine. Mm. It's drinking all the bottles and bottles of wine that make your face all swollen and make you piss your pants.
When I went to the psychiatrist to get my Wellbutrin, I told him that I drink around 15 beers a night. Thank you. I'm a hero. But I told him I drink around 15 beers a night. And you know what he told me? I can't stop or I'll die. I swear to God. He's like, well, don't stop now. You're in too deep.
And I'm so
like,
you're essentially in the middle of a movie just called Crunk. It's like Crunk, but you have
just
to
like
stay
have
drunk.
To be. I literally went to the deli afterwards like, doctor's orders.
Doctor's orders. Oh my God. Just hear your kids all hiding in the other room.
Doctor's
like,
orders.
My prescription just got filled.
Daddy, why is there a kegerator in the fridge?
I have the same thing. When I went to the psychiatrist for the first time, I was smoking 2 packs of cigarettes a day, and they told me, don't stop.
Don't stop.
Keep going.
These shills for big booze and big tobacco?
I legitimately think they were scared of both of you. I think there's that a point where it's like my therapist who just kind of sits farther and farther away from me, who's canceled two... My newest therapist has canceled 2 appointments on me.
You're paying them.
What?
You're paying them... For a fake friendship that allows you to be somewhat emotional and they refuse to do it.
Why won't they just stay? Why won't they stay?
I think it makes them complicit in whatever your future crime might be.
Let's play another fucking video. What is this one, Trav? What is it? Oh, wait. Go back. Wait, try it.
Oh, I love this little guy.
Try it. All right.
I know who this little guy is.
All right, start again. This is for Kissel. Now, this is one of my favorite ones I've seen in a while. This made me laugh along fucking by myself.
Is it Norbert? You're going to love this little guy. Right. It's something close.
All right. Oh my God. Definitely got a little Chihuahua mix in there. It's amazing. It is seriously better than Limp Bizkit. It's better than any music from Soul Asylum. Oh my God, his friends are rocking. This is incredible. I gotta follow this. Is this an Instagram dog?
I don't know what this.
I have got to follow this dog.
Guy, I'm on his little feet.
People are like, oh, they might be torturing him to make him do that. They're just showing him pictures of, like, pork. They're showing him food.
Those little dogs have permanent faces like that. It's like like Wendy always looks like a refugee, like we took out of the concentration camps. Or she's always just like...
No matter what, no fur babies were... Oh, look at that.
Plenty I disagree with the genealogy.
Now, oh, look at that cute dog. Wow, I got to find that one on Instagram. What's the name of that one?
It's called like heavy metal, like poo poo, something like that. It was something
that
like
was more
that.
Of a Gigi Allen song.
I guess
the band is called The Bubbas.
The Bubbas?
Oh, wow.
No Bubba.
KFitz99 is trying to make me feel better by saying, Henry, don't worry, my therapist committed suicide. So thank you for that. And you know what? I do feel better.
A rare occasion where suicide does legitimately feel all right.
I feel so much better. Thank you very much. Very sad. Wow. I'm certain it had nothing to do with you.
No. It's got to be a horrible job being a therapist. Who would go into that profession?
It has to make you
so much less sympathetic to anyone in real life. You know, when you're a comedian, you just want to be serious unless you have to be funny. You want to get paid for it.
Only the asshole ones are like that. I like joking around like normal. I don't understand the professional comedian. Every single professional comedian I've met, like above our level, are so fucking miserable, and I don't understand. You just joke around for a living. Therapists get into it because they get off on secrets. I think that's how part of what they do is they get into it because there's like a little bit of thing because they have total control of your fucking ass. If I had that guy at some point, I've been in places where I'm certain my therapist could have been like, you need to eat a dozen bananas a day. And I'd be like, all right, now I'm just eating bananas and then fucking whoo.
What do you think was the conversation that made your therapist, the second therapist, by the way, end the relationship with you?
Oh, man.
Hasn't ended it yet.
Canceled twice.
They just been,
don't you think that's like?
I honestly think that he's going through his own personal crisis. I think he's dealing with some weird shit.
Okay.
And because the last conversation we had, I did not yell nearly as much. So I feel I'm good.
Okay.
Yeah, I feel I'm good. I got a therapist. Yeah, it's fine. And now I yell at Wendy, and then it's mostly just I wish I had some kind of like, fucking. Robot in the car that I could yell at, that it goes so I can feel like I'm hurting something. You know what I mean? Like, something
I'm sure
to
you
get
can set up your Alexa to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, that would be so cool. Go, oh, thank you, Henry. Thank you for complaining. Henry, thank you for complaining.
Your love of robots is so strange. And also the accent that you have given to your fake robot is interesting.
Weird.
Oh,
yeah.
Thank you, Henry. Thank you, Henry. So kind.
And then you've expanded on it. Very good.
I didn't do anything.
I'm going to get another DM. Thank you.
I just feel that you have to. It's fine.
Everyone
it's
yells
a
at me for when Henry does something offensive. I don't know why. I can't. He's in L.A. Otherwise, I'd grab my little neck. But
you get me. The problem is my therapist really did balk at KS Magic. That was the biggest problem. Was me describing chaos magic. And they
my therapist was super into chaos magic. She was down for it because it helped.
I think your therapist is trying to like start a weird secret affair with you.
Ooh.
Is that a bad seed to put in your mind?
Oh no. She's not.
Not
you
happening.
Said that she's cute.
That
though,
almost
right?
happened in The Sopranos.
Ooh,
that did
Sopranos.
Kind of happen.
Did it
happen?
No,
it
that happen. That was like the whole first season.
Oh,
of Sopranos.
Oh my gosh. That's, I could handle people murdering each other, but extramarital affairs?
Oh, disgusting.
God. Come on, Tony.
Let's fire another video down the pipe. I don't. What is this one? What is that?
Code name ropes.
I don't remember it.
Let's discover it all together.
I got pretty drunk when I did a bunch of
these. Graduation. I really did not want to get a real job.
Oh, Wisconsin.
Like I just didn't want to have to put on a suit and interview for a job that I did not want. So yeah, I thought, well, whip making. Let me see if I can make a living doing that.
This guy.
This is Wisconsin.
Yeah! Fuck
I think I've seen this before.
Look at this.
He might have been my neighbor.
Oh, yes! This shit fires me up! This is
incredible.
Adam Weinrich, I believe is his name. He's a champion whip!
Woo!
Whoa, dude!
Yeah!
What the fuck? Oh, so dangerous!
Sir, your whip is on fire.
And guess what? He is also bald.
Is he really?
Yeah.
Dude, look at him fucking whipping like a motherfucker.
He kind of looks like the guy from The Hills Have Eyes.
Yeah, he does. Watch this.
One sun kiss down.
Look at this one. Wait, Marcus. Watch this.
Adding a musical component.
Okay, cool. Harmonica. Mediocre.
Love it.
Mediocre.
Yeah.
Mediocre. 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 What is he going to do?
Oh, shit.
Whoa, just his lips. Whoa!
I don't know about that one.
I pulled my...
Seems like...
Woo! Here, no!
Yeah, you should have been in the band with this guy. The old body slaps the brow.
Woo!
Looks like you're toning up a little bit. Let's
see if I can get through the whole thing again.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, look at this one. Watch this one. Holy shit. Turner, this guy gets so much Ren Fair fucking Bush. They call him the Bushmaster.
Does he get paid for this, I wonder? Right?
Yeah, he does. Circle. He's a champion. He's a champion at this.
I don't know if that means he gets paid for it.
Yeah.
You, if he does it, you can go fuck yourself.
What Travis, is even? Could you look up whip championship?
Yeah, what's the maybe?
Oh, look at his sassy spin.
Ooh, Magic Mike.
Funny.
Ooh, Magic Mike.
Routines in there for you, Cameron Cato. Thanks for watching. My name is Adam Winrich. If you want to learn more about me or buy my whip cracking instructional DVDs, check out winrichwhips.com.
Winrich Rips!
Honestly, Winrich by Wisconsin Rips. Standards, that guy is a total stud. He is. He's got a good bod. He's got a handsome face. He's obviously knows how to use
so
a whip.
So much. Fucking split slime on him. That
I don't
he
know
can't
if you can say that.
Shoes.
That doesn't. Wow. Well,
he
maybe
is covered with snail sneeze, man.
Oh,
he's got it
goodness.
All over his fucking knees.
I don't even
knees.
Think snails do sneeze.
Whoa. His lap is
By
as
the
slick
way,
as a seal's forehead.
I had touched a subway pole a week ago and just covered in what I would assume is snail slime because I don't want to think about what it actually was.
It's
and it was disgusting. Yeah,
it's
it was
not.
So
no, a lot of
I like
snot.
Vomited in my mouth and it was devastating.
I couldn't find a whipmaster salary, but I have a circus ringleader at $51K a year.
More than a teacher! No. Seriously!
You
that
need to tell me.
That is crazy! Also, don't arm the teachers. Give them whips.
I don't see, this is why I did a joke about this on Twitter about it was about how comedians should be carrying whips.
Oh.
But I think that it's interesting that you get paid more for a job that we beg other people to do. I would pay to be a circus master.
Sure.
Well, circus master, that's a very finite job market there. There's not a whole lot of circuses around anymore. I think Ringling, Barnum & Bailey, Ringling Brothers Circus just shut down. So the circus master jobs are few and far between. A lot of competition there.
It's like radio DJ jobs. You have to keep those jobs. Also, high rate of suicide. Mm-hmm. Also,
really?
What radio DJs are the
sad.
We're the
it's
saddest of all.
The drive time isn't a fun time to be talking to people
on
radio.
No,
it's a very sad nomadic life that pays very little.
Brittany wants to drink her whole bottle of wine, Henry, so she's requesting you take off your shirt more. I don't know what that means. Also, Katie Romeo says, guess it's time to channel all that extra testosterone into the whip arts.
Yeah.
So use your high T to learn how to whip.
I am going to put it this way. By the next mandate, and this is true, I've already purchased a bullwhip to arrive at my home. I will learn how to use it, and I will use it in studio.
That room you are recording in right now is not large enough for bullwhipping.
Nor is the new studio that we got in. What? You're just
I can get one in. I can get one in. I think I get one last slight. I'm getting Dickies is saying we can.
Okay.
Dickies is saying we can, and I'm just going to do it. Because it comes down to is once it gets down to your mandate, the responsibility and power that you have, like once you have the mandate to just both entertain yourself and others is so great and so big that you have to bring it every single time.
I'm only going to be worried if you start like tying broken glass shards to it, hard rocks, things that might make me feel like you're actually going to go commit a violent act.
I'm just hoping I can get really good at it. Cat Goddess is saying you have to practice a lot with whips or you can get hurt. My back was split open with a bull whip. Yeah, of course.
Very much so.
But I put in the work.
We can all start bringing in our own like little fun things. I could bring in my bass guitar on my next mandate.
You can do whatever you want.
This is what I was saying to do. You got to do it.
Yeah, I'll bring in my bass. I'll lay down.
Bring in my recliner.
I'll lay down some licks.
Yeah.
Y'all saying no? You got? I've been saying this for fucking like a year. You
yeah,
brilliantly Seinfeld your way through the whole episode.
You know what show is funny? Frasier.
That
show.
We're not going
holds
through another. We're not going through.
No,
another
I know
Frasier.
We already did it, but I tell you, I've been watching a lot of Frasier, and it's so much funnier than Seinfeld.
No,
it is. Seinfeld's, negative.
Better.
Negative. That's fun.
Very much so.
So I also, and I do like it, Marquis Des Moines saying that there should be a last podcast whip enthusiast group that we can meet. And I actually really do agree with that. What is the next video there, Titties?
What do we got here?
Also, I want to say, Titties, thank you for the work he edited. That was from four different whip videos. I spent
really?
About an hour and a half watching whip videos.
Well, thank you, Travis. Very, very nice. Right. Great work.
Let's bring the mood down.
Yeah, let's get everybody. Okay, now, first of all, before we play this, What's your saddest memory?
Well, I didn't want to think about that.
Yeah, I didn't want to think about that.
But
either.
I already got it.
Yeah, I got it.
You know
it too.
How we've been feeling good? Like Marcus specifically said earlier today that he's feeling good. Kissel's feeling good. He's
had
up
a
Ryutrin. He's getting his shit all tightened up. Throw it all away.
Yeah.
And let's get sad.
That was in San Francisco area, looks like.
Oh, why?
I'm not
this
sad.
Is sad. That's sad. Oh. He's sad.
No, he's not sad. He's just playing. Okay, that's sad.
Oh my God, Henry. Why would you show this?
It's very sad.
I mean, maybe he survived. I think everything is fine. No, it's just a baby. It's maybe a little early birth.
Born in captivity. I'm sure it's not sad. It's that okay. I'm sure that orangutan survived.
I think so. Of course.
Yeah, I bet it wasn't shot in the back of the head.
It wasn't. What was the name of the one at Jonestown, Mr. Bubbles?
Mr. Muggs.
Mr. Muggs.
You forgot so fast.
Yeah.
You
forgot so. I accidentally became an expert in Jonestown, and you've already forgotten Mr. Muggs' name.
No, I didn't forget. I asked what it was to test
know.
You.
He's not even an orangutan. And it's actually
whatever.
Not pronounced orangutan. It's pronounced orangutan.
No, I don't think so.
Orangutan.
I don't think that's true.
It used to be two words.
I want a little panda.
Orangutan.
It's orangutan. Man of the forest is what his name means in something.
Really? Sergeant Pepper Dimples. Find him on Instagram.
Yeah, you're just talking about
that
sticker.
I love stickers.
There's a lot of people. We're getting a lot of people saying the same thing again and again about us doing commentary on Drag Race, RuPaul's Drag Race.
Honestly, I haven't seen any of like the last multiple seasons.
I've
I don't
never
get this.
Seen it.
Is it TLC? What channel is it on? I don't
know.
I don't know. I think it's Logo.
Carolina agrees Frasier is better. Thank you so much for your support.
I'm angered by you, and I'm angered by this. My problem with, I don't have a problem with Drag Race. I try to watch it. It's just like a lot.
Nah. I have no problem with it. I think I would absolutely love it. I just haven't,
it seems
I
like
don't
an,
know where it is.
It seems like an exhausting show to watch.
No, it's a competition. There's a lot going on, but you know, it's
intense.
This
comes from a man
I'm a huge RuPaul fan. You know that story about my brother had the poster on the wall, a classic little stand-up that I used to do.
Mm-hmm.
I did not know she was a man at the time.
So you just jerk off to her all the time.
Beautiful woman.
Yeah, but it's like, it's okay for you to want to have sex with her.
Yeah.
Yes.
Even
yes.
now. Even yeah. now that you
yes.
know for a fact. RuPaul has a penis, right?
Yes. No, yeah. he identifies as a he. He's not transgender. He's a drag queen.
Mm.
It's different.
Yeah.
He identifies as a man.
Yeah.
He just dresses. That's all fun. It's just fun.
Fun and games.
It's fun and games. It's classic.
You say, dude, oh, they want me to do Drag Race. I would crush it.
I think you might have to shave.
I can't shave. What would be underneath it?
When you shaved.
I know.
What would be underneath my. What would be underneath? Can you imagine
oh,
this?
Oh, my God. You would have to shave the whole thing.
This?
It's just, it somehow looks worse.
Yeah, there's, see,
are you growing a tail?
Yeah.
I think you have a tail.
That's weird.
What is, are you like, what's
what
the
is
name?
With that
speaking
little...
of Seinfeld, George Costanza in the movie Shallow
this?
Hell, he had a tail.
What is,
no, above.
No, it's, what is that weird patch
dude,
that's surrounded
oh my
in,
gosh.
Like, it's
this?
Hairless all around.
That's
yeah,
a
what's
tail.
That? What is that?
That's what is... my patch. That's
all
my,
right,
that's
Paddington,
where the bunnies
sit
go.
Down. There it is. Yeah, show him there. That's
No.
That's Shallow. Is that Costanza in Shallow Hell? Creepy tale. Great movie. Oh, actually, maybe not. I don't remember.
I think it's weird.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
I can't imagine shaving. What's next, Travis? What do we have? What's entertaining?
So we got a George Norrie and Jesse video.
Okay, so what's important about this is that people listen to the chat to watch the show? Who actually listens to Coast to Coast? Who actually does their homework?
I got it because you gave it to me as a gift.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I listened to it multiple times.
Yes. Now, my thing is what I realized at some point is that I had never saw George Norrie actually speak.
Mm, yeah.
Really?
I've seen pictures, but I've never actually seen him. Now that I think about it, no, I've never seen him speak.
Huh.
I've never seen him in person, so I did a little trail and a thing, and it's pretty great.
All right.
To see him in live and in person next to the incredible, incredible, dynamic interviewing force that is Jesse Ventura.
Jesse Ventura has won at everything.
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy.
Now, I could only get this 20-minute video down to 7 minutes, so just let me know when you want to tap out.
Maybe
oh,
never.
Yeah.
Maybe
I mean, never. I will never. I'll never stop. I'll watch the whole goddamn thing. It's pretty interesting.
I'm not going to tap out.
He takes you coast to coast every night.
Off, right off the grid, but he has a television show, which I think is hilarious.
Yeah.
He's everything. Yeah.
Truth teller.
President?
Preventer off Maybe. The grid. Hell yeah.
Welcome George Norrie to Off the Grid. And the first thing I got to say, George, how ironic this is. You're now on my show, and it's the middle of the afternoon.
Oh, this is fantastic. It is early like, for me, Jesse, but
him.
I would do anything for you. So it's
he looks like
here.
If Pugsley grew up and became an accountant.
Post night after night, week after week, with those, let me say them bluntly, ungodly hours you live at.
And holidays, and I'll tell you something, Jesse, that not a lot of people know. I've been doing this now for 11 years.
Not that
I've
long.
Accumulated 33 weeks of vacation time. I've taken 1 week. The only way it's going to end, Jesse, is when my producer Tom comes back after a commercial and says, George has passed on.
I'm like George Carlin. I worship the sun and I enjoy
seeing him. I worshiped him. I worshiped him. Everything that he did was incredible. He is one of the last performers and best entertainers.
I'm going to bite you. People want to be informed. They're tired of being taken advantage of.
Yeah.
You know, I always use that phrase from the movie Network. We're as mad as hell and we're not going to take it anymore. People are fed up. You know that because your program here, Off the Grid, deals a lot with people's frustrations.
Yes.
And that's what we're starting to do now on Coast to Coast.
Well, yeah, I'll tell you, you're good. Wonderful. I love doing your show. Like I said, the only problem is when you do it.
Stop harping on that.
Hashtag
it's not going to change the fucking time slot for you, Jesse.
It's at night. It's a nighttime show.
It's a nighttime drive show.
I can look up into the stars and the heavens and see it like probably nobody else can when you're
sometimes you want to jump up to the sky and I want to grab a cloud. I want to eat it. Hope it's cotton candy.
Like fireworks, because that's how
he could do that.
And often I lay there and I think to myself, it's impossible. There has to be life beyond the earth.
If I could just get a hold of an alien, I could wrestle him and see if he could handle the 10 count.
Every solar system is the same. There are planets everywhere, and it's just a matter of time that you're going to have a planet that has intelligent life out there.
You know how many times I talk to scientists and I ask them, is there a candy planet? Something's made out of a peppermint or something made out of a caramel, some kind of caramel river.
That also boggles your mind.
Oh, yeah. You're starting to go. Like, I remember I went out to I
just want some sweet tea. I want a southern porch.
This is a bus stop in Las Vegas.
Just
establish a perimeter.
Eat crackers, drink wine, and look out at the universe through that telescope, which Vice President Gore let us do. Well, they had, like, the top scientists for whatever there. And
brutal.
He told me something that night that I looked at him and I said, you know, I didn't really need to hear that.
If you say that one more time, I'm going to come over there. I'm going to snap your head against the wall. I'm going to snap your legs with my big forearms, you stinking scientist.
You know where our knowledge lies. But with what we know today, everything is slightly curved. So he said, theoretically, if you left this planet and could travel to the extent, you would ultimately end up right back here.
That, there's no doubt about that. You know what's most impressive?
I love it. George Norrie is a great interviewer. Yes, and roll into it.
He just says, yes, the icicle treatment. Yes. This is a classic video of dueling senility. I like this because they don't. We could probably stop this.
We can stop it. That's a great interview. I'm going to watch that show Off the Grid. I think he's on Russian TV, which I will be on Thursday at 8 p.m.
Were you colluding?
Yeah, I am on a regular basis.
He's been
Ed Schultz
for a while now. Yeah.
What's Ed Schultz?
He had a show on MSNBC for a while, and then
he went
to RT. What are
these shows that you do? What are these shows?
It's just weird. Just a life of weird.
Are you doing Al Qaeda television too, that Al Jazeera?
No. I would though, and I want to get on frickin' InfoWars, but Alex Jones is too busy looking at trying to get Hogg on the show, the kid activist.
I mean, that's got to be a very locked room to get into.
I think it's tough. They don't like to be, just imagine calling him a big fat dumpy idiot to his face.
They don't like to be challenged at InfoWars.
No, because it's all so shallow
like
nonsense.
They have their own little world.
Yeah, I know.
God, it used to be so much fun, didn't it?
Yeah, when it was,
I miss him. I miss back in the day. I miss being innocent and free. I miss that, but he's taking it from us, that little meatball man. And now we got technically the only person sticking up for us is George Knorr, and he keeps selling rations and flashlights. All he's obsessed with selling flashlights. And I listened to another episode of him recently for the Hudson Valley Triangle. The same exact shit where he was just like, so tell me, when you saw the boomerang, were you afraid it was going to come back? Because that's what boomerangs do. So I'm like, just stop it. Stop it, George.
And that's a good segue into the flashlight that he has to sell to see the boomerang.
Yeah.
Good.
Flashlights are great. You actually use a flashlight. You never need a tactical bath or a sperm-killing pill that is not FDA approved. That's what Alex Jones sells.
We're getting a lot of people saying the reason why Alex Jones can't let you on the show is because you showed a video of live death.
I did not, and I don't believe that he died. I still don't believe that.
You can say whatever you want.
Heckler died. He was a heckler, really.
It just seems like it seems like you're trying to twist reality into whatever it's going to be, man. But guess what, man? It could be fucking. Next video, please.
InfoWars shows a lot of live death, by the way.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
I hope this isn't a live death video. Oh, my God. Okay, he's fine.
This child died.
Yeah, he did not die. That child is fine. That actually looks kind of fun, to be honest. Even with the fall at the end, I might take the ride. Also,
fucking James Dean.
What a malicious little girl. My goodness. She's a killer.
I think he's dead.
No, the kid's fine, but she definitely pushed him off a cliff.
Well, he's definitely been touched by an angel now, which means he gets to sit on a special bus and go to special classes and will never have a normal life.
Well, you know, we all had to experience the small bus sometimes.
Well, every bus was small to you, you fucking gigantic person. My mandate. That's the next video, jeez.
All right. Ooh, this looks kind of fun. Oh, it's a heart.
This is an homage to my adopted city.
We've seen this kind of stuff before.
Yeah, we could probably just...
No. It's called manualism.
See the beginning.
Manualism. Manualism. A.K.A. when you're in solitary confinement.
Yeah.
The only band around is you.
Breezy Briff says, in Ben's world, everyone is fine. They never get old to me.
Ever. You know, I can never do this with the armpit. A lot of the kids were doing the armpit thing.
Here he goes. He does the entire song.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's not actually.
This might actually be Anthony Kiedis under the bridge doing heroin. I think this could be him.
He's just doing it on his own. Like, he's just doing it in his recording studio and be like, they'll never believe it was me. I want to get it here. Click until it gets big.
That's very good. Take me. Look at that. You know what? So we get paid to do this show.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny? What is the image?
I think that is New York City Times Square. It's where you're at.
Yeah, that's like a mile and a half from here.
Yeah, but what's that thing? Is it there? Am I like missing a thing?
Balloon. It's a hand with ink making it.
That's it.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh. Thank you.
Manualism.
Yes, man. Red Hot Chili Peppers, I just have such a love-hate relationship.
Yeah, I mean,
they're awful. Why?
But they're not. This, I love this song. Yeah. I like a lot. What was it? Blood Sugar Magic or whatever?
Blood Sugar Sex Magic. Yeah. Suck My Kiss is fine, but now it's awful.
Yeah, it's just also silly.
Yeah.
Yeah, sadly, you got me in the video
in a good way, and sometimes it's silly in a bad way.
I mean, I guess we'll play to the rest of it.
Might as well. Emmy Tor says, I consider paying for cable to see Ben on InfoWars. InfoWars is not on cable.
No.
No, it is not.
It is a very internet-based show.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's next, Travis? We're going to do calls last 10 minutes, so I wonder what's next. How many do I have left?
Not many.
All right, well, let's give it a go here. Do we have some calls lined up? Any good calls lined up?
I don't know.
Give me
yes,
the
I'm
suck.
Getting nods.
Give me the suck.
What on earth is this?
Just touch the tip. Put the pinky up my ass. Baby. Slurp, slurp, skeet, skeet. Who wants a nut on their face? I'm going to nut. Another one.
I just don't like the idea that someone actually really is. Oh my. I don't know if aliens could handle doing that kind of drug.
Yes, you should watch the documentary Love and Saucers, where we may be having some extra content that happened this week that involved people having very graphic sex.
All right, I'm going to watch that aliens. Tonight right after the live stream, and then we have a special Patreon content as well coming out soon. Thanks for the great responses to Creepypasta. I got a couple of fun stories out there right now.
Honestly, you can't imagine having sex with an alien?
I can imagine it, but you can imagine a series of things that I don't want to have happen.
I actually do very much enjoy pornography in which the woman is painted up to look like an alien.
Hmm. You ever see the one with SpongeBob? Have we talked about that?
I've seen the one. Yeah, Skin Diamonds in that one. She plays the squirrel.
Did you jerk off to that?
Yeah.
I don't think you're supposed to.
I
don't know. I don't know.
Skin Diamonds super fucking hot.
No,
I have a significant squirrel. Issue. With jerking off to people dressed as children's characters, except for Scooby-Doo, only because there are specific women built into Scooby-Doo that are built for everybody in whatever mood you're in.
Mm.
All right.
That's your response? You have never, about this once.
I never sexualized Scooby-Doo. No. I never got this. I never did. I did not sexualize Scooby-Doo.
Name a cartoon.
Because they're cartoons.
You must have had sexual feelings about a cartoon at some point. What is
The only one would be Jessica Rabbit because everybody did, and that's the one that I bring
up.
Easy.
That's
it. That's the bullshit answer.
It's
not a bullshit answer. That's an answer.
There's not another one that you remotely sexualized.
No. Cartoon?
Cartoon.
Yeah.
No comic book character, like none of the like the X-Men.
I didn't read comic books. Nope.
Like Rogue or Psylocke.
No,
or
I thought they were superheroes.
But you like fucked a tree stump or an orange, right? Didn't you fuck an orange?
You fucking orange? No.
What you did something not... weird though, didn't
no,
you?
No, that's
you
not me.
You did something like that.
No.
I'm pretty certain.
No,
it's
you are thinking of a different friend. I assure you. I do feel like I recall a story being told about something similar to that though. But no, I never did that.
Somebody that we know did.
I think it was maybe on an episode of Roundtable they talked
That's
about.
That's what
it.
I'm thinking of.
But no, it was not
me. I think it was Holden, actually. I think Holden fucked something really weird.
A lot of people are saying that Kissel has a Marmaduke obsession.
I do have a Marmaduke obsession. As a matter of fact, I still have a Marmaduke cartoon in my wallet.
Right, let me see if I can. This is a no spin cycle zone.
It's a no spin zone.
Oh, no spin zone.
Play the next video. Whatever
I'll
we got.
I'll find the Marmaduke. Where the heck is
this? Now, guys, this is the world's biggest guitar.
Thick. It's 9 times the length of a standard electric guitar.
It's a big guitar.
What the heck is my mom doing?
Seymour Duncan pickups. Nice.
Look at this. Look how big this guitar is.
What's the point?
A television series produced for the Discovery Channel.
Whoa!
Where everyday items were recreated on a frightening.
Look how big it is!
It's just a big guitar. There it is.
Big stuff.
Think of science as being entertaining, but if you look at some of my most popular shows, Monster Garage, Monster House, Big, Motorcycle Mania, Biker Build-Off, they're all about people using science, math, and engineering to create some of the most outrageous contraptions you've ever seen.
Titties.
It's just big.
Man, look how big the guitar is going to be.
And I want to see how big this guitar gets to be.
What
is,
can
are
you
they
play
gonna
it?
String it?
They better string it, otherwise it's not a guitar.
Yeah, Peter fucking Frampton is going to play it. Fuck yeah, dude. Whoa, Peter Frampton's doing it!
So Peter, but like, what are you up to right now? Like, what are you doing these days?
I'm playing the guitars then. Whoa!
Sounds so
he's
dumb.
Playing
shit.
It! Watch this. Fuck yeah. Oh yeah, shit!
Is that Eddie Money?
Yeah, buddy.
That guitar didn't work.
Is a big guitar.
Oh, we are so dumb. Anyway, here is Marmaduke. Now, this is, this is my friend Timothy Schultz gave this to me way back in the day. It must be 11 years old now.
Yeah, you showed that to me like the first week we met.
Marmaduke, stop. This is a no spin zone. And you notice he's spinning there. And on the back is a commercial for Ricardo Antonio Chivarrero. Chivarrera?
Let me see if
I can. For Desperate Housewives, which I think is a hot show at the. So I have that, and I also have a $1 bill that somebody gave me that says mass shooting not in Washington, D.C. again. And I've held on to that. So.
That's good.
I don't know what that means.
I like it.
Yeah. Not happening again. Oh, we lost Henry. Uh-oh. He unplugged. Something horrible happened here.
Hello.
Uh-oh, and we got 10 minutes left. We're supposed to be doing the calls. Oh, my God. Can they still hear us?
Yeah, you guys are still alive.
We're live.
We're still alive.
So well, don't worry.
Sorry, it was because I got up to dance to Peter Frampton and I pulled out the car.
Really?
Frampton
will do it.
We're going to do this shit.
All right, let's do a call.
Let's do a call and see what's like, see what you guys hope. We got some interesting stories. You're going to go live on Last Stream on the Left. You're talking to 1,100 people. For the love of God, be entertaining and help my mandate be the best it can be. You're live.
Good evening, gentlemen. It's the motherfucking Bomb Podcast.
Kim,
what's up, brother? How are you?
What's going on, buddy? I haven't talked to you in a while.
That's all right. It's all right. We missed you. Thank y'all for bringing the stream back. I know everybody loves that.
We got to, man. It's our life's blood.
Kissel, I cannot wait to wrestle you. I want to wrestle you right now.
Oh, we got to do it.
You want to wrestle me?
We got to do it.
You want to wrestle, bump?
KY Jelly. KB in KY versus BK. That's how it's going down.
I want to see it real bad.
Slippery as it comes, huh? Little snake.
What would you do, Bump? How would you, like, what's the first move against a man Kissel size?
Honestly, it's, you got to take his knee out.
Well,
you gotta hobble that
no,
that
he's got bad feet.
Yeah.
you just go to work. You go to work on the downstairs and bring him down to your level, and then you tire him out.
Like you know what I used to do in high school very well, sprawl. You kick your legs out, they try to get it, you grab them by the back of the head, you slam their face into the mat, and then you spin around them, you score 2 points, which is quite a bit of points, and then from there you just ride them out.
Interesting. You know what I always thought I would do is I'd show up and be like, hey, Kissel, I got you this new microwave. And be like, oh, cool, something to heat up all my soup, or whatever it is you do in your house. And then I'd go, huh, bop you in the head with it, you fall down. I fucking choke you out, then I call the hospital to come make sure you're okay.
Oh, well, that's nice. I don't know if it's a no-holds-barred. I think that's extreme rules you're talking there, which I'm not sure if I signed up for that.
I wanted to tell you, again, Ben and Marcus, thank you so much for your hospitality when I was able to visit you guys.
Oh, it was great to hang out,
man.
Buddy.
Fuck yeah.
Fucking great night. We yelled at each other for like 3 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So when I was in, and I sent this video to Travis, but when I was in Poland, I ended up at this place in the Polish mountains called Western City, and it was a Polish version of, like, Tombstone. Fuck. And there was a Polish guy there that did a whip show, and I sent the video to Travis, and he has it. I sent it to another friend of mine, and he goes, "Oh, my God. I would love to see Henry play with a Polish whip." And I said, "I think he's been playing with one his whole life."
Yeah!
Let's see this guy.
I call it my Polish sparkler, though.
Absolutely. So have you guys seen anything about...
That might be the same guy from Wisconsin.
We're watching it right now, Bump.
We're watching your video now.
It honestly could very well be the same guy from Wisconsin. I'm sure he's Polish.
You can tell he's Polish because he's whipping it backwards.
So while I
have to tell you guys what I did, the dog video kind of changed my story for tonight. But while I was in the mountains there in Poland, it was New Year's Eve. I was in pretty rare form. And during the fireworks show, fireworks everywhere, I saw this little dog, and he was, like, earning his PTSD badge in this moment, right? He was freaked out. He was dodging, going left and right. He didn't know where to go. And I couldn't rescue him. I knew he'd bite me if I even touched him. So about 15 minutes later, I see this drunk couple looking for the dog. And the man's arguing with the woman, telling her, it's your dumbass dog. You brought it out here without a leash. Now we can't find him. Spend my New Year's Eve looking for your dog. So I thought the only way I could make it better was to go inside and get a Bluetooth speaker and hide it beside the next cabin and then play a dog barking on that speaker. And they would start walking towards it, and they'd be getting excited, and then I would turn the volume down like it ran the other way, and they would get all dejected.
You fucking cruel
and start
bastard.
Looking around.
It ain't right. To do that to the Polish
debunk.
And I had
this going for like 10 full minutes.
Well, I actually think it's refreshing to play mental games with people, because then you get sharp, and it gets everybody sharper.
Yeah. Absolutely. Hail yourselves.
Hail Satan, bro.
Thank you. Watch the man who should be Polka King. What was it called?
The man who would be Polka King.
Oh, my God.
It's great.
Yeah, you've been talking about this. You really like this. I got to watch
it. One of the best documentaries you could ever see. All right. Do we want to do one more call?
Let's do another call. We got 5 minutes. You're live. You got 5 minutes. You can make this fucking memorable, because this is a big deal.
You know, don't give me shit, Henry.
Whoa! You're calling into my fucking bullshit! You're calling into my fucking bullshit!
Oh, my God.
Yes? So what would you like?
So I'll make it quick for you, okay? I grew up in the Hudson Valley.
Yeah.
I grew up in that town that Indian Point is in.
Ooh.
Oh.
And I swear to fucking God, I was coming home from a date one night, and I'm driving past the power plant, and the sky was illuminated with, like, this really funky teal color, and it was really fucking creepy, and that was that. Another time, I'm up in New Paltz, New York, which is about 45 minutes north in the mountains, and I'm rolling up a joint with my boyfriend at the time, and I look up, and it almost looks like there's a chopper in the sky. And we're looking at it, and I'm like, you see that? He's like, yeah, I can see it. And we're looking at it, and it just goes to the right. We're like, oh, that's a little fast. Comes towards us a little bit real fast, and then it just, like, starts going in fucking zigzags, and then poof. It was just
wow, Hudson Valley sighting part
what
two.
What year was this?
It was what?
What year was this?
Oh, shit. 2013, 2014?
Back in the day. I like that. It's kind of crazy.
Not that
far. Well, thank you so much for your info. I want to see if we can get one more call in. Thank you so much. It's a great story.
I want to get one more call in, but out in Salt Lake City, I just moved out to Salt Lake City. My roommate was walking by Ted Bundy's house with her boyfriend, and they saw a fucking black figure off to the side of the house, and she just got the fucking chills.
Oh, my
just
God.
Just saying.
Yeah, well, just I don't think it's Ted Bundy's ghost, but it's something like
it. Oh, no. Thank you so much.
Either way.
One more quick one.
I want more. There's just more UFO stuff. Like, that's really what energizes me at all anymore. That's what gets me up.
Yeah, your shirt didn't give it away.
All right, you're alive and last stream on the left. You're literally the last call. You're literally the last call. So tell us what you're hauling.
Oh, shit, boys. I didn't think this was coming.
It did.
How's it going?
It did.
So, 2003, there was a sniper alongside a highway here in Ohio, just shooting at cars. My mom's best friend's mother was actually the only person killed by him. Well, honestly, I mean, as young as I was, one of the first times I probably realized just how shitty things could be with people. But he apparently was a paranoid schizophrenic type dude. Thought commercials and television shows were talking to him.
They are, though, dude.
Yeah, but you're supposed to just, like, buy the eggulator, the thing that makes scrambled eggs
better. Look at Instagram. Instagram makes ads specifically to you. It's making these gunmen correct.
All right.
That's why I don't use half of it anymore. It's bad. But, say something. I've been just reading articles. I don't know why I've been so focused on it the last couple of days for some reason. I've been listening to old episodes of last podcast and just, something made me think about it, I guess. But, say something about Michael Jackson. The article said he wanted the news to stop about that, so he decided that he'd make the news about him.
He trumped
it. Yes, he's gonna beat Michael Jackson in the headlines. Just like Farrah Fawcett did. Okay, buddy, thank you so much.
Concrete things off cars, off of overpasses, and he shot at 20 some cars. And
God, well,
there it is. I feel like I'm in a bar in Ohio. I like it.
Well, hell, Satan, I hope he doesn't do it again.
Hail yourself, buddy. All right, there it is. The Henry Zebrowski mandate.
you know. I actually had a bunch of videos that I have put together.
Well, yeah, go out with one.
I have a bunch more. I don't know if we have any left. Do we have any left, Travis?
We have zero.
Zero
okay,
left.
Good.
You
I
right
had
there.
Some left built. They'll be there. So I'm excited for next mandate because we can really... ratchet it up.
Well, I'm excited to see you and your whip work. I think it's going to be very good.
I think we're doing a titties mandate next week.
That's
yeah,
it.
We are.
Hell yeah.
Hail yourselves, everyone. Talk to you soon. Love
Hail
you.
Hail Satan. I'm going to come back with a new skill, and everyone's going to be very sorry.